All right. My name is Afiq Abdul Hamid, and this is my first time stepping up as a spoken word poet. Before this, I've done some rounds on the science communicator circuit, so I'm going to see now if I can work it. So this first one's a little bit about me. One, two, three, four. Lend me your ear, give me your time, so I can give you a tour of this life of mine. I'm a rebel, a runner, a real boy wonder, with words like a kip and a voice like thunder. 25 going on 26, with big dreams of being a great scientist, notably an astronomer, one with a whole lot of Instagram followers. I think science is a real noble goal, just one of the things that make my heart whole. If I could, I would explore the stars with my mind, no telling what wonders up there we might find. Hands up, reaching for that new horizon, like the NASA spacecraft that flew past Saturn, on its way to visit Pluto's moon, Charon. Its setbacks and nice pictures and pattern, all of which make for a really good lesson. So get ready, because school is in session. One, the universe is a really big place, and there's no room for ego in all that endless space. And two, Pluto's not a planet, but it does have a moon, one I'd like to visit one day very soon. And three, the universe is in you and it's in me, ancient and vast from which we spring, along with billions and billions of a lot of other things. You feel alive right now? Scream! I said you feel alive right now? Scream! Because we're living the dream. I came here with all of my team. Are you my team? I came here with all of my team.
I came here with all of my team.
Yeah, thank you. Alright. Of course, this is really my first time doing this. Previously, I come from a scientific background. I love science, and it's something that really makes me think a lot, and I think that's very healthy. I have done rounds as the science communicator. Did Fame Lab earlier this year, which is a 3-minute science talk, and now I'm here. Hello, everyone.
Hello.
Hello, Malaysian Poet Society.
Hi.
Anachoic Cafe.
Yay.
And communist. But like our friend, this will be my last number for today, and it's about love. Because everyone loves a love poem. Mm-hmm. For some reason. Does it go again? One day I sat down to write a poem about love, thinking that since I lived it, it would be enough. But I realized that it's made of some really weird stuff, and it's not perfect, it won't fit like a glove. So I approached this girl, who I thought was a dove. She led me into her world, whom she said had it rough. 9 months later, bliss has departed. I still feel that she's hella kind-hearted. She puts up with my rhymes, my misery and jokes, and swears it can only come from copying old folks. But I think it's okay, though, that she's sometimes cold. Summers turn to winters, that's how the story goes. Yeah. I might marry her one day. Given the Lord's grace, I wake up every morning just to see her face. So take some time to heed this advice, that relationships aren't sometimes always precise. Live and let live is all that suffice. Peace and take it easy, because it must be nice, yeah.
Must be nice, live a life of luxury.
Must be nice.
Must be nice.
Yeah.
Must be nice.
Explorer, wanderer, thank you, Max.